Fairtex from Thailand. Jihin Radzuan from Malaysia, the Shadow Cat.
Jihin immediately comes out, takes center circle, tries to put stamp on her back foot, but there comes those kicks that Rich was talking about. Nice little hand combinations on the inside. She shoots in for a double leg. Good sprawl from Stamp, showcasing defense with that wizard on her right side, trying to pull up Jihin, not letting her get underneath those hips.
Radzuan with this early takedown attempt.
Good takedown defense by Stamp right there. She's already starting to make her frame here on the clinch, but you can see Jihin strong in the clinch here, pushing Stamp against the cage like this.
Stamp with her back against the cage, trying to escape, throwing knees to the body of Jihin.
Yeah, I like Jihin keeping that pressure, keeping things nice and tight so Stamp can't utilize the clinch and start throwing those elbows. She's really good at that, especially with the redirections inside the clinch to create the space, and then she'll find time to throw those elbows. So it's really smart for Jihin to stay nice and tight, start looking for those trips, and start chaining these takedowns together. If one doesn't work for her, she has to have a plan B.
Still trying to take her down against the fence here. Opening round, the judge, the bout judge as a whole, 3 5-minute rounds in this MMA bout.
For this match, Jihin did a lot of grappling. You can tell by her ears that she has been putting time in on the mats, Rich.
Absolutely. I tell you, though, I like what Stamp doing here, framing. Jihin initially was really working, you know, in this clinch, able to use her head to maintain position. But here, Stamp was able to push her head away, and that's how Jihin ended up losing this takedown on the way down, trying to commit to that. Stamp ends up on the mount here.
Tough position here for Stamp. 2 minutes into this opening round, Jihin tried to escape.
Yeah, Jihin's got to scramble. Good job to create space with the hips, get back into half guard. She's got the underhook on the right side. She's got to stay off her back. She's going to use it to get back up, take the back of Stamp. Beautiful back take right there from Jihin. The Shadow Cat's moving well early on. Nice defense.
What a great scramble by Stamp there. You can see that once she defended that takedown, she actually landed a knee on the exit of that thing, and it led to two more knees on the ground.
Yeah, she isn't just trying to defend. She's trying to have offense in that defense by utilizing those knees and those short-range elbows. But Jihin's being relentless on this takedown attempt, has her hands locked. Stamp could go for a ride right here. Man, the balance of Stamp is tremendous. But Jihin's able to muscle her down to the ground. See if Jihin can work her way into a more dominant position.
We knew this would be the game from Jihin. Try to take this thing to the canvas.
Stamp looking for that switch there.
Stamp's got good defensive wrestling, the way she's keeping her back up against the wall, so she's not gonna go flat under her back, so she can work her way back up. Jihin needs to turn her off of the cage and try to get her back onto the floor. Stamp needs to keep her back there so she can work her way back up. She has to try to pull one of those legs out or create separation in her legs so the grip starts to break of Jihin. You can see Stamp Fairtex is reaching in between the leg there of Jihin so she can hit that switch and so she can create a little bit of movement. But Jihin's keeping her legs nice and tight. She might try to triangle the legs here. She's gonna try to put her legs around the legs of Stamp Fairtex so she can get a more dominant position.
She's gonna have trouble though because that grip that she has around Stamp's legs is just low. There you go. And that's what Jihin needs to be doing is lifting her and pulling her out away from the cage like you mentioned earlier, Mitch.
It's good awareness of Stamp though to keep this position, keep herself safe. But she's got to do a little bit more movement because Jihin's going to make these minute little adjustments. There you go. If she keeps punching, she's going to be able to try to find that space and try to get one of her legs free. If she wants to get up, she has to remove one of her legs or at least break the grip of Jihin. This is a strong position for Jihin to be in, or at least ride out the rest of this round.
Elbows to the top of the head of Jihin.
So you can see she's trying to triangle the legs and trap the legs in between hers.
30 seconds to go, round one.
See, now Stamp has the break. Now she's got separation. She might be able to work her way back up onto her feet.
She eats a couple of bites on the way up, but she does get to her feet, the Stamp Fairtex.
You know, that was a stand-up that was like 90 seconds in the making the whole way through.
And she comes out with a heavy right followed by a stiff jab inside the final 10 seconds. Fairtex gets to her feet and starts swinging to close round one.
I say this, that was a high energy round from Jihin, and that last shot for me looked a little slower than her initial shots. So I hope that ended up costing her in the second and third.
And she did miss weight too. So all these things are gonna factor in to when minute six starts.
She wants to put you on the fence. Get away from the fence.
Yeah, you're the top. I am your third birthday night.
Jihin Radzuan from Malaysia, the shadow cat, trying to take the fight to Stamp Fairtex. Stamp is the golden girl, for the most part, has lived up to the highest of expectations. Again, inches away from winning in the first round against Angela Lee. Huge strength as you're striking, but her defensive ground game is excellent. We saw that in round one.
Yeah, but it's not going to be enough to win. You have to create offense. You can't just play on defense. You can't lean on that. So she has to create some offense here. She has to be attacking. Even if she's on the bottom, she has to be firing. I know she wants to be safe and defend. But look at that. Nice little touches there by Jihin.
Missed with the first left hook and then found the range to the face of Stamp.
Trading leg kick.
Yes.
And then a nice touch there by Stamp.
For good measure from Stamp, then another.
That lead hook of Jihin's doing good work. Because you can see how low Stamp carries her right hand, right? She keeps it cocked and loaded, ready to just fire it. But Jihin, with this pressure, is moving forward, but she's getting touched on the entry now. Stamp going to the body.
Straight right to the body, and then that jab of the face of Jihin.
You can see the little snarl that develops on Stamp's face, how she gets focused and intense as she starts to let go of some of these strikes.
Yeah.
Nice left hand there, again landed by Jihin.
Great defense.
What a sprawl by Stamp Fairtex.
Yeah, Jihin's doing her best work when she's moving forward, because it doesn't allow Stamp to just get into that timing and keeping her at range with the combinations. You see there, moving forward, caught Stamp on the way in.
Oh, she hurt her with that right hand.
There coming in.
Oh, she jumps around, takes the back, has the arm trapped.
It's a bad position for Jihin.
Jihin in trouble.
She only has one arm to defend this choke.
Look at that. Stamp Fairtex has the arm trapped with her legs. Jihin's able to get it free. Jihin's comfortable here. She's spent a lot of time grappling. She's some high level
under the chin.
Stuck it under the chin. Jihin's got to defend. She's got to peel that arm off of her head.
Oh,
it's getting tighter.
Stamp.
Oh, great job by Jihin to peel off the top hand.
She doesn't have the rear naked all the way in. Stamp, if she wants to be able to finish this, needs to go to a short choke there. Start applying that pressure with the forearm to her back. I would switch to a gamble grip here and use the forearm on the back on this short choke, but Jihin's doing a good job of defending this choke all the way around.
Jihin has to defend the right arm of Stamp Fairtex, and then she can peel off the left arm, which was underneath her throat. Now she's got two hands on one, and she can work to spin into the guard or create a little bit of movement here as Stamp Fairtex has her back. Good defense from Jihin. She's comfortable in this position. But Stamp Fairtex is dangerous on her back. We've seen that. Good job working herself underneath the chin.
2 minutes to go here in round two of three.
Stamp's a bit high. She has to get a little bit lower if she wants to create a little bit better angle. But there it is. She's got the body triangle now.
I don't like the way she's got that lock, though. It's high on the foot, and that's going to put stress on her ankle.
But it's up against the fence, so Jihin can't really put pressure on that side to create the separation. She can only go to the knee side, which she did just there, and Stamp's going to be able to adjust that body triangle. See how she's inching it, trying to push that foot in deeper into the lock? Jihin has to put her body onto the foot side of that lock. She can't go into the knee side. But the wall is preventing her from doing so.
Stamp with a barrage of lefts to the face of Jihin. Not doing a whole lot of damage.
It's adding up on the scorecards, that's for sure.
Yep.
not only is she in a, one of the most dominant positions you can be in, but she's scoring, not only just trying to choke, but she's doing damage as well. There's Jihin trying to turn. Let's see if she can get around.
Final minute, second round. Jihin trying to turn the tide here.
Stamp could transition to a possible armbar, but I don't think she's going to have that right angle.
Yeah, she's
going to have to try to get her left leg over the head of Jihin, and Jihin is trying to smother her. Close down any offense coming from Stamp. Looks like Jihin's safe. She's going to spin into the guard here, try to ride out these last 30 seconds. Dangerous position that Jihin just survived.
Interesting here that Stamp's holding on to the body triangle.
Yeah, she should let it go and start to do work.
20 seconds in round two. The number one contender, Stamp, the number five contender, Radzuan.
Don't forget to take into account here the Stamp trying to work in that choke. You don't know how hard she was squeezing on those various chokes. And that could wear the forearms out, you know. Oftentimes when you see an athlete holding onto a position like this triangle, it's a sign that they've fatigued.
Stamp feeling very good about herself. Stamp dance again inside the one circle.
She doesn't look that fatigued to me.
No.
When Stamp's dancing, you know she's feeling good, Rich. Look at this. That was the right hand, right? You can see it was the failed shot right there. Boom, got caught with the knee on the entry. Knees to a grounded opponent, perfectly legal. Look at the way Stamp traps the arm, jumps to the back, starts working for the choke. Jihin, being the veteran grappler that she was able to go two on one with the hand, peel it off, and then turn into the guard of Stamp Fairtex.
Okay? You're doing a good job. Finish her up.
Yeah, you're doing really good. Keep her on choke side.
Let's go. Last 5 minutes, Stamp.
5 minutes to go. Stamp Fairtex. Jihin Radzuan. Two world title fights yet to come here in Singapore. One on Prime Video 2.
Good back and forth action. Jihin's trying to keep her boxing nice and tight, but she got caught.
She got caught. She's on her back. And now a barrage from Stamp Fairtex.
This is what we talked about. Jihin standing in front of her rather than pressuring forward into that clinch.
Heavy elbows. Jihin bleeding from the mouth.
Big shot by the number one contender as she's got Jihin Radzuan on her back, dropping elbows.
Absolutely hammering away at Jihin, trying to survive here. With 4:14 left in the third round.
Big elbows coming from Stamp. Jihin's trying to keep her close. She's got double underhooks pulling her in, just trying to regain her senses. She knows that she's not supposed to keep her back flat on the mat, and she's supposed to angle off and get her side onto the mat and get a little bit of movement going on, but I think she's just trying to recover here from that big shot and those elbows that came down from the guard of Stamp.
Yeah, Jihin's too experienced of a grappler to just grab hold of Stamp like that. She's obviously doing this to keep eliminate any kind of space that Stamp can get for the strikes, trying to give herself enough time for recovery.
Stamp postured up, but that gave Jihin the opportunity to regain full guard, and now Stamp's looking to do ground and pound damage. Jihin's got her feet up on the hips. She's going to look to do a little bit of attacking from the guard. You can see how high she gets into her guard, like she's putting her legs up near the armpits of Stamp so she can threaten with possible triangles and arm bars. But Stamp presses her against the wall so she's not able to create any movement. Stamp can trap her, that'll drop elbows.
Yeah, I still don't like that pressure on Stamp's shoulder. If I was her or in her corner, I would be trying to clear Jihin's left leg there, which she's done.
Yeah, Jihin's probably looking for an arm bar. See how she's trying to trap the arm? She might choose to shove the arm down and look for a triangle, but you can see the angle that she's creating by going horizontal to Stamp. She's looking for the arm bar. Yeah, Jihin might try to push that head, circle her left leg over the face to get the arm bar, but she's right in Stamp Fairtex's corner. and they're guiding her step by step through this defense of this possible submission attempt coming from Jihin. Jihin has two submission finishes off her back, both triangles, so she's very comfortable here. She knows what to do, but Stamp is just imposing her will on Jihin by keeping her smushed up against the wall.
This one.
Yeah, I would like to see
more activity.
I would like to see Stamp looking for the finish here, posturing up, breaking guard, looking to actually pass guard, some sort of superior position. Because she's not going to finish the fight in this position.
Inside the final 2 minutes.
Keep in mind, Jihin's the kind of athlete that if you mess around too long in the guard like this, make one little error, she will snap into a triangle or an armbar.
But the corner sees it. The corner sees what Jihin's trying to do, and they're guiding Stamp through it. They're saying, watch the armbar, be careful with it. Jihin transitions to the head control, and that just eliminates the posturing ability of Stamp. But Stamp still finds a way to create a little bit of space and then start dropping the elbows.
You see the damage to the mouth. Three big elbows to the face. Radzuan.
Yep, there she goes. She's trying to throw it up. There's the armbar attempt. Oh, it's tight.
Here
see
comes.
If Stamp can fight out of it.
Stamp in some trouble now. The tides have turned.
Oh, she's out. But Jihin's on top. What a scramble by Stamp. Stamp's going after a leg.
Stamp's going after a leg lock.
40 seconds remaining as the action picks up.
Bar. Look at Stamp Fairtex breaking on the knee.
Stamp's trying to lock
wow.
it in.
This would be crazy if Stamp wins via knee bar.
Jihin able to wriggle free with some shots to the body of Stamp.
Stamp able to recover guard, get back into full guard, and stop that possible guard pass coming from Jihin Radzuan. Very tough. Jihin's not done yet.
10 seconds. Final 5 seconds of this very entertaining fight. Women's MMA on her back, Stamp, and that's it. Stamp Fairtex, Jihin Radzuan. Entertaining stuff from these two women.
Very entertaining match. Very entertaining match.
Stamp Fairtex proving she is evolving into a complete mixed martial artist. Great defense of the takedowns there in rounds 2 and 3, and then just to out-grapple Jihin. That was impressive after hurting her on the feet like that.
Here's the elbow from Stamp.
Yeah, you can see this is where Jihin stood in front of Stamp without that forward pressure, and she just allows Stamp to do what Stamp does, and she steps in hard with that arm. This is what I was talking about here, Brent. You know, even though Stamp is in her corner and her corner is giving her instruction, Jihin is the kind of athlete that, you know, you slip up and she's gonna find something, but Stamp, she's full of heart. Not only that, she's the kind of person that says, oh wait, you're gonna try to armbar me? Well, I'm gonna do a knee bar. I've never done one of these in a match before. And let me show you how I've evolved as a fighter.
We saw a bit of everything over the final half of that final round. Tom Lau with the decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 3 rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All 3 judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision, Stamp Fairtex.
Stamp Fairtex, unanimous decision victory.